Good morning. Welcome to day three, finals day of the 2017 International Women's Flat Track Derby Association playoffs here from Malmö in Sweden. It's 12 o'clock midday local time here. I'm Sven. I'm sitting here with Dimauer.
Hello.
And we're going to be your voices for this matchup between the number 7 seed Stockholm Roller Derby from Stockholm in Sweden, coming in rank 20 in the Wftda rankings. They're going to be facing off against the number 9 seed in the tournament, rank 29th in Wftda, Kallio Rolling Rainbow, who skate out of Helsinki in Finland. That's going to be quite a matchup, so we've seen them a few times already this weekend. What are your thoughts on how they've been playing so far?
They've had great games. Stockholm has faced Terminal City. They did that on Friday, and they won that game. And then they faced Denver and had a great game there too. They took half of the points. And today we're seeing them against Kallio. And I will give you the names, the rosters for the game. For Stockholm Roller Derby, we have number 11 Maureen, 131 Cracker, 16 Panic at the Hex, 18 Mount Everest, 27 V for Vagilante, number 4 The Incredible Fox, number 44 and your captain Ylva Arnberg, number 46 Sweetheart, 55 Fury, 56 AM Chaos, 67 Test the Mess, 817 Scandi Crush, 87 Little Slinky, and 96 Linda.
They're going to be playing in the blue today, as you see them on your screen. They're going to be facing against Kallio, and their roster looks like this. 103 Bella Glucosi, 13 is Mischief, the captain. 19 Cutty Schrodinger. Number 2, Aika Helpo. 27 is Jay Karpov. 31 is Karma Sutura. 410 is Wata Vima. 4444, Do Me Behind. 49 is Machu Picchu. 5-7 is Lionheart, 6-0 is KO, 7-7-7 is Gilbert, 9 is Teabag, and 9-1-1 is Chaos. We're about 40 seconds, so we'll run through the skating officials for this game. So head referees, Duncan Disorderly. On the front of the pack, we've got Jean-Claude Grand Slam. Jam refereeing, we've got Rorschach and Divide by Zero. And then we've got Bully Hayes, Don Scorleone, and Chunk Rock Girl on the outside as OPRs, with Mercy B Coop as our alternate ref for today.
Our head and soul for the day is Iceman, and on his crew you'll find Alias Stoned, Dr. Stevel, Blandaya, Twinkie Darfur, Joe Kerr, Ergy Battery, Ace Satu, Josephine Bacon, Sassanik, Nurse Bamwollen, Riff Ref, and Strange Edge. Hope I got all those names right.
And that takes us into the rolling whistle, so we're about ready for 5 seconds from Dr. Stevel. Starting off with AM Chaos in the line for in the blue for Stockholm against Karma Sutura in the white for Kallio. Karma Sutura already been rolled back.
And we see how Sweetheart goes up in front, waiting for the jammer to come, but they are heading away to the cheese balls bearings penalty box for a back block.
So now we've got AM Chaos out with lead for Stockholm, coming up the pack on a first scoring pass on this power jam. A lot of tight action in turn two, but AM Chaos able to slide through the inside, picks up the 5 points. Stockholm just trying to hold a goat, but not able to do that. Ylva Arnberg is up inside the Kallio 4, trying to break it up as AM Chaos comes round through turn three.
And we see Karma Sutura exiting the penalty box, and Stockholm ready in a wall in the back to take it on.
So 5 points scored in the power jam. AM Chaos forced to the infield, picks up another 4, calls off the jam. Karma Sutura able to get through a pass, but no scoring pass picked up for Kallio. So the score as we go after jam 1, 9 to the Stockholm All-Stars, 0 to Kallio Rolling Rainbow.
And Stockholm has been to playoffs before. 2016, we took 7th place in the D1 in Vancouver, and 2015, 7th place in D1 Dallas.
So we're going to have Lil Slinky now for Stockholm against Gilbert from Kallio. Gilbert tries to bounce up the outside straight on one toe stop, but is forced to recycle back behind Linda. Lil Slingy, however, though, is pushing her with past the pivot line. She's got a rolling Kallio 3-wall in front of her. Gilbert bursts through the inside, picks up lead. There's a forearm being signaled. It is on Gilbert. So I don't know if that means that lead was given after. It looks like we're not going to get a new lead given to Lil Slinky. In fact, no, we are. Lil Slinky, that's been relayed. Lil Slinky is, in fact, officially lead now and has picked up 5 points on this power jam.
This is the second power jam in this game given up by Kallio to Stockholm. And the last one, they put up 9 points. So let's see what Lil Slinky can do this time.
Well, Lil Slinky's already put 10 on the board for Stockholm. As we get back to 4-on-4 in the pack, as Fury comes back to the pack from the cheese balls bearings penalty box. Kallio with a flat 4 at the front. Stockholm just holding back in the passive defense. Now moving up with Mount Everest and Fury trying to break up that Kallio 4-wall. Teabag doing a good job just staying in front of Lil Slinky all the way. Lil Slinky, though, able to use that amazing toe-stop agility to bounce up the infield straight, picking up another 5-point pass. Meanwhile, Gilbert is back to track now, forced to the infield by Fury, who unfortunately follows her out for the no pass, no penalty. Gilbert now completes the initial pass. Lil Slinky in the pack, looks back down the straight, sees Gilbert, calls off the jam for a 3-point pickup.
And sponsoring us here in Malmö is Rydell Skates, the innovative leader in roller skates for over 70 years. And check out the new Rydell Solaris, the performance you demand, the comfort you've been missing at rydellskates.com.
Next up, we're going to go to Chaos on the line in the white for Kallio against Maureen in the blue for Stockholm. Maureen takes a little hip check to the inside, but realizes she doesn't step out, so she's going to motor on back up through the pack. Ylva Arnberg with the knock to the infield of Chaos, who's now started that pass again, being held up behind Cracker. Ylva Arnberg and Incredible Fox is doing a great work swarming the jammer. At the front of the pack going into turn two, Maureen is being held up behind Machu Picchu. Chaos able to break through, pick up lead for Kallio.
This is the first lead that Kallio has had this game. 25 minutes left in the first period.
Maureen hot on the heels of Chaos as we go into the pack, coming up the jam line. Forces the call of 0-0 for both jammers in that one.
Great point protection by Stockholm Roller Derby there on that jam.
Yeah, it's great jammer awareness. She knew that Maureen was probably about 25 feet behind her when she's coming in the pack. I think she tried to get the quick points, but called the jam before Maureen could get in. So 27-0, just under 5 minutes. Just under 5 minutes played in this first period. Kama Sutura lining up for Kallio, and that's going to be Panic at a Hex for Stockholm. Panic at a Hex making all the movement at the start now, just muscling her way into turn one, being held up by Teabag. Wattu Vima taking her all the way back to the mid penalty box straight, and she's going to start that move on the pack again.
And Panic at a Hex was being held in the back and gotten up front, pushing the Kallio wall, but didn't get the lead.
So we've got another jammer race now. 10 feet separates the two jammers as they come up the pack, speeding up now. Kallio racing at the back, and again we get a forced call off. It's a great hustle by Panic at a Hex to chase down and get that pressure on again, protecting the points, as you said earlier.
Well, yesterday we saw a different kind of a game where the team that was behind in points, they would keep running it in order to score points, but this is not the case today. So I'm really excited to see what's going to happen in the future in this game.
So Lil Slinky for Stockholm against Gilbert for Kallio. Lil Slinky with a burst of speed from the line through her own wall, but is Gilbert able to find the gap through as we get a forearms penalty called? It looks like it's going to be on
number 5-7 to Kallio.
Lionheart picks up the forearms in that initial hustle. 1 point picked up by Gilbert. So the first scoring points on the board for Kallio in this game.
And Kallio has had 3 lead jams in these past games and has had just 1 point scored. So good point protection, Stockholm.
So we're going to see Chaos versus AM Chaos. Both walls starting just up near the pivot line now, rolling back. Stockholm with the back 4. Both jammers forced off to the inside. AM Chaos resets and takes the outside line round, followed by Chaos. Fury picks up a forearms call in that pack melee.
And going to the cheese balls, bearings, penalty box. And so is Vatuvima from Kallio Rolling Rainbow. And AM Chaos is your lead jammer. And just calling off the jam.
Great hit by Doomy behind there to knock AM Chaos into the inside of turn 1-2, forcing the call off. 4-point pickup though by Stockholm, taking our score 31 points to 1. 22 minutes and a half left in the period.
And as I said before, Stockholm has been to 2 previous playoffs, but this is Kallio's second year at playoffs, Stockholm's third.
2 very well-versed teams in the experience of playoffs.
And Panic at a Hex is your lead for this jam, but Kallio's 3-1 is right behind them.
That's Karma Sutura, so we've got about 40 feet separating them as Panic at a Hex comes into the pack. Takes a hit from Lionheart, calls off the jam, but Karma Sutura still able to get in. 3-2 in favor of Stockholm in that jam.
And Kallio's going strong with a 3-jammer rotation. They have number 3-1 Karma Sutura, number 777 Gilbert, number 911 Chaos.
And now we've got for Stockholm Maureen and Gilbert for Kallio. 4-on-4 in the pack. Kallio with the back wall. Sorry, 3-on-4 in the pack. Kallio with the back wall. Maureen takes a skip to the infield, then gets held up in the hustle in the middle of the jam pivot line straight. Gilbert just bouncing away through the pack at the front, picks up a lead for Kallio.
And there is the pivot for Stockholm going to the cheese balls bearings penalty box for a track cut.
That was Mountain Everest with the track cut. Kallio put 4 on the board. Call off the jam, so they're slightly clawing it back. 20 minutes and 40 seconds remaining in the period. 34 points to Stockholm, 7 points to Kallio Rolling Rainbow.
And Stockholm has a 4-jam rotation. They have number 1-1 Maureen, number 5-6 AM Chaos, number 8-7 Little Slinky, and number 1-6 Panic at a Hex. Those are your jammers for today, unless something else happens.
So Little Slinky now makes the first move, slides through a rumble. Great move there by Chaos. Sidesteps up the inside line, picks up lead. Little Slinky is out now and chasing. Half a lap separate the two jammers as Chaos comes into the pack on turn 2. Takes a hit to the outside from Sweetheart, calls off the jam. 3-point pickup for Kallio, shutting out. Sorry, no, 1-point goes up for Stockholm. 25 points the difference, 35 plays 10.
And with little under 20 minutes left on this first half of our first game today, we have a lot to see, I think.
25 points is nothing in roller derby, so it's easy way this game could swing in momentum. AM Chaos on the line for Stockholm against Karma Sutura for Kallio. Karma Sutura just trying to find a path through, but gets bounced to the infield. Came on in front of the pack, looked at the jam ref, thinking that she'd maybe done enough to seed the call. Jamref gave her the beat to see if she was going to seed.
And we have a skater down on the track, so there's going to be an injury call-off, unfortunately. But I will take you right out to our Powerdyne, brought to you by Rydell. And Powerdyne has changed the game again with a newly redesigned Aries Platinum. Aries Platinum Performance Redefined. And the Powerdyne Planes and Performance Skates products, their cutting-edge designs and cutting-edge performance, you will find them at the RydellSkates.com.
So we're talking before there about the jammer rotation. So obviously AM Chaos is just being escorted off now, helped by the medics. So we've already seen that we've seen the same jammers come in the rotation. So now do you think there's going to be... Well, obviously AM Chaos is going to have to sit out for at least three jams.
Yes.
So we're going to see that change the rotation slightly now. Be a bit more work for Maureen and Lil Slinky.
Yeah, I know that at home games sometimes number 27, Vifo Reglante, has been a jammer. We haven't seen them jamming during playoffs, but who knows? Or else they will just go on with a three-jammer rotation.
Well, we're going to see Panic at a Hex. Remember, we are on a power jam from that last jam call for injury. Panic at a Hex takes a quick move, takes a whip off Scandi Crush round the outside of turn one and just managed to muscle away through... past Machu Picchu to pick up lead as we get a clockwise block called on Ilva Onberg for Stockholm. Goes to take a seat in the cheese balls bearings penalty box.
And Panic at the Hex is out and through for 5 points as Kama Sutura is out of the penalty box and still on their initial pass, getting hung up by Sweetheart, and now just bursting through the pack, neck by neck, with Panic at a Hex, who's calling it off, saying that I'm not going to chase you down that road.
As we said, we're going to see some good strategy here in terms of point protection, just trying to limit the damage that the other team can do when you've got the control. So the score, 44 points to Stockholm, 10 points to Kallio Rolling Rainbow, 18 minutes, let's say, left in the half. Remember, if you want to give us a shout out, go to at WFTDA Live and use the hashtag talk the number 2 WFTDA, and you can join us in the Twitter sphere.
And a quick lead there from Maureen Phillip for Stockholm.
Gilbert still in the pack as it comes around turn two, just takes a hit from Tess the Mess, which sends her into the infield. Phillip tries to do an apex jump, but a good hit from Watuvima sends her also to join Gilbert in the infield. Now both jammers in the pack as we're on the back straight.
And there is a failure to reform on Mounty, the pivot of Stockholm. When your ref is calling a no-pack situation, then you really need to stop blocking. Otherwise, you'll end up at the cheese ball bearing penalty box.
And just at the end there, it looks like we got a penalty on Wftda. I think it was a forearms call. Who will now start as the pivot for Kallio in the cheese balls bearings penalty box.
So both pivots in the box. So a 3-3 start.
With Lil Slinky lining up against Chaos. Both jammers trying to make a move through the separated three walls now. Both bracing. No pack is called. Reforms quick enough for the refs. Lil Slinky gets knocked to the outside but does pick up lead. So Lil Slinky lead. Gilbert now, sorry, Chaos now out in front for Kallio. Lil Slinky comes through behind half a lap, sees that Chaos is in front, calls off the jam 0-0.
And I saw the bench coach for Stockholm telling Lil Slinky to run it because they had their pivot in the box and they went to get the pivot out, but then there was a switch. So number 131 Cracker went to the box instead.
So it looks like we've got again three blockers for both teams lining up near the pivot line. Kama Sutura and Panic at a Hex. Slow roll back by both sets of blockers. Stockholm have the back brace and they're now holding Kama Sutura. Panic at a Hex just gets knocked to her knees and now goes to go around her own blockers, but Kama Sutura managed to put her down before she starts to re-engage. Does Kallio blockers, helped out slightly by Mike Neverest, who comes out of the penalty box.
And a low block is getting assessed to Tess the Mess, who is taking a seat in the penalty box. So lead goes to Kallio Rolling Rainbow and number 3-1 Kama Sutura. And there is a forearm being assessed to Panic at a Hex, who's taking a seat in the cheese balls bearings penalty box. So this is a power jam for Kama Sutura. It was a cutting, sorry.
We've also got Cutty Schrodinger going to join in the penalty box. with a clockwise block in the pack, which got whistled at exactly the same time as that cut track. Kamas Wftda calls off the jam, unable to get any points on the pack of that one as we get a team timeout called by Kallio.
And the team timeout is brought to you by the 888. 888, which will give you helmets, pads, wrist guards, and we've got you covered. Protecting Derby since day one. You will find their protecting gear at the 888.com. And I was just told that this was the first power jam that Kallio has had during this first half. Sorry. And Panika is just sitting in the penalty box during this team timeout. And don't forget, if you are watching or if you have anything to say to us, hashtag on Twitter or Instagram or Facebook, the talk number 2 WFTDA. And because we would love to see you and what you're doing and what you think. This is a power start for Kallio.
And it's going to be Gilbert who's taking the honours for the power start, but it's slight pack advantage to Stockholm in the penalty killing position. They're going to try and fill that jam line. Cracker staring down Gilbert in the brace position. Gilbert forces the way past Incredible Fox, picks up lead straight out of the gun.
And Sweetheart is getting goated in the back by Kallio, trying to get through. But Panika is out of the penalty box.
Panika's out of the penalty box, star in hand. Looks like she's going to try and hand it off to Incredible Fox. No, she's actually gone past Incredible Fox now into the back of a Kallio three-wall. Machu Picchu with the move to take her to the outside. Just being rolled back by Bella Glucosi.
And a multi-play being assessed to Stockholm's captain, Ylva. No, Sweetheart.
4-6 called on the penalty, not 4-4. Gilbert with an easy step round turn two for a 5-point pass of the pack.
And back on check, you see Cracker for Stockholm, but getting hit and out by 1-9, who's also have taken a star pass.
So Incredible Fox now has the star for Stockholm. Great little duck there to take her underneath Cutty Schrodinger. So she's out now on the initial pass. But a great jam, power jam it was for Kallio there. 18-point pickup brings us now to a 15-point game. The Stockholm 48, Kallio 33.
This was the highest jam scored for Kallio during this half, matching the 18-point jam that Lil Slinky had during jam two.
So we're going to see Maureen for Stockholm. And that's going to be chaos for Kallio. Both jammers roll up to the pack, which is stationary just in front of the pivot line. A lot of tight movement in there. The pack is not moving at all here. Little stepping movements. Both jammers having to work hard for the money. But it's Maureen that's out in front with lead. Forearm call to teabag for Kallio. Heading around to the cheese balls bearings penalty box. Maureen through for a 4-point pass, calls off the jam.
And Lil Slinky lining up now, who is the lead scorer for Stockholm, has scored 19 points during this first half.
So we're going to see Lil Slinky now against Kamas Wftda for Kallio. Stockholm once again holding that back wall on the jam line. Kamas Wftda though, great footwork to get her up the penalty box straight on the outside, pick up lead. Bella Glucosi put Lil Slinky out on turn one, but picked up the forearms while doing so. Now it's up to KO to take Little Slinky back, but she's also going to go to our cheese ball bearings penalty box.
And so is the jammer for Kallio Roland Rainbow going for a track cut. So this is a power jam for Little Slinky. And an illegal procedure, I think, was given to test the mess. I didn't really see what happened, but there are a lot of points scored by a Little Slinky so far. 5 points on the board.
Ooh. Lovely little jump there to get Little Slinky through for the 5 point pass of the power jam. Kama Sutura comes back to track now, but immediately is knocked off by Cracker, who rolls all the way back to the exit of turn three with Kama Sutura following. Kama Sutura again favouring that inside line, trying to do a lot of the toe stop manoeuvres.
And Stockholm giving up test the mess in the front to go to do some offense.
Test the mess with a great move there, just stopping both of the Kallio blockers from recycling, but does pick up a penalty in doing so.
And I think this is their third penalty this half. So they will have to, we'll see how that impacts the game.
Kama Sutura able to slide easily round turn one for her, for that 5 point pass.
And Little Slinky trying to do the shirt whip, but didn't really quite get it. But that, was that a little apex jump I saw there in the end?
Kama Sutura, I think, tried to take the, a spinning move on 1 foot through the inside line. We're going to get an official review.
And this official review is brought to you by 888. Helmets, pads, wrist guards, we got you covered. Protecting derby since day one. And 888 also protecting against rotational violence with MIPS patented brain protection system. Go to their website, 888.com.
So this official review called by Stockholm.
I wonder what they saw. Did you see anything?
I'm not sure what they're going to... there was nothing that I saw in the jam that would make me think that they were looking for extra penalties. I wonder if they're maybe looking to get a penalty rescinded.
Maybe.
We're just seeing on the replay here, Little Slinky with that hit off from Teabag.
Well, it could be that they would like to take away a penalty from Test the Mess, who's been very good this first half.
Yeah, there was a great move by Test there when there was two Kallio blockers trying to recycle the jammer, and Test just took one to the outside, one to the inside. And we're going to get Duncan Disorderly now.
Stockholm are requesting a blocking out of bounds penalty be assessed on a Kallio blocker.
Okay.
So there we go. We're not sure which blocker it is, but we'll find out if the official review is upheld or not. So Stockholm looking for an out of bounds block on one of the Kallio blockers.
Yeah, and during this official review, we'd like to take the time to talk about our We Believe and the UN Women program. Through our international giving program to support global change, We Believe, the Wftda is raising $15,000 for UN Women's One Win Leads to Another program, which uses sport to develop leadership and economic skills in young women and girls. Find out more about We Believe and the Wftda's partnership with UN Women at wftda.com/donate. And don't forget that the top four teams from this tournament will be joining us at the 2017 International Wftda Championships in November 3-5 in the City of Brotherly Love, Philadelphia, live from the Lycora Center. And the tickets are on sale now. And from this weekend, it is going to be Gotham, Denver, Crime City, and London Roller Girls who are going to Philly. Roll into champs instead with a 3-day VIP ticket for $160. With that ticket, you will get the best seats in the house, lounge with a private bar just for VIPs, exclusive Sunday final countdown party during the last game with complimentary drinks, 2017 championships program, and a VIP badge and lanyard. Limited quantities available. So get your VIP ticket now at wftda.com/champs.
And we're just waiting now as Duncan Disorderly relays the result of the official review to the bench staff. And now we're going to get it relayed back to us. So let's listen to what is said.
The Kallio blocker was assessed to have re-established their position on the track before engaging. The no call stands. Stockholm does not retain their official review.
The no call stands. Official review lost. But it was a breathing for the Stockholm team.
Yeah, it was a good long official review that. So again, it's a good time to regroup and get your head back in the game. Also a good time to change momentum that Kallio was building up.
And Kallio scored 18 plus 19 points in the last four jams.
Gilbert for Kallio is out with lead. AM Chaos, I think this is the first time we've seen AM Chaos back since that injury. Now with the star in hand.
And Sarah Gilbert, the highest scorer for... No, the next second highest scorer for Kallio with 23 points, but now the highest scorer with additional 5 points, which brings them up to 28.
So Tess the Mess is just waiting with Linda at the back to railroad Gilbert off the track, but a great move by Bella Gluclosi. Clears the way so that they can get through to continue their scoring pass.
And it's great from Kallio to give some assistance to their blocker, checking in with the back, what's happening, do you need some help? No, you don't. Okay, then I will go and help my jammer to get some points and get through.
Gilbert is just pressing against this brace three of Stockholm blockers.
And it's like Gilbert is waiting for their wall to come up and help.
Finally, we get the star pass now, and that is Mount Everest taking the star for Stockholm to becoming the jammer and just rolling around, being helped by Tess the Mess to be able to get through. But Tess the Mess picks up an out of play block, and so does Linda at exactly the same time. So two Stockholm blockers are going to go and sit now in our cheese balls bearing penalty box.
Yes, and it is a tied game with 14 points on the scoreboard. Now Kallio taking the lead with 66 points to Stockholm 65 with 7 minutes left on the first half of the first game of the third day.
But some penalty trouble for Stockholm already, as Cracker 1-3-1 and Tess the Mess are both showing 5 penalty trips at the moment for us.
Yes, it's an official timeout going on now on the track. I didn't really catch why, but...
Oh, it looks like they've rescinded the penalty from Tess the Mess.
Yes, I see
that. Tess the Mess is now only on 4 penalties, but Cracker still on 5, which means that Stockholm do have 3 blockers on track now as Maureen smashes away through past Wftda. Got Keo and Matthew Bichu in front of it, a beat now, coming around turn 2. Forearms called on Machu Picchu, though, as she tries to stop Maureen, who's now out with lead. Also, Keo now picking up a clockwise block.
And Jay Carpo had their first jam during this game and forced the call off there while chasing the pack in the back with 4 points. So there's a lead change, 69 to 66.
And we also had Incredible Fox, the pivot for Stockholm, picked up a cut track in all of that as well. So busy cheese balls pairing, bearings penalty box right now. And we've also got 2-on-2 in the pack with Chaos against Panica to Hex. Chaos takes the inside move. It's a race to who gets out front, but it is Chaos first. Panica to Hex now closing the gap down the hip to hip as we come into turn 3. And once again, contact from Panica to Hex, who floors Chaos on the jam line. Chaos calls off the jam, but Panica able to get through and pick up 2 points. 3 points. 72 plays 66. 5 minutes 40 remaining in the period.
And that is because you pass one blocker, but you have two in the box.
Of course, we've got the still got plenty in the box to pick up. So it's now 3-2 on track. Karma Sutura and Lil Slinky.
And I understand the bench wanting to draw the jam out in order to get out their people from the penalty box.
So the pack rolling slowly back. Lil Slinky finds a way at the middle, picks up lead as Karma Sutura was bounced to the infield, moved back to turn four, but now out, completing the initial pass.
And Lil Slinky getting knocked out by number 6-0 from Kallio. That is KO.
Stockholm bench, I think, is going in looking for the low block, but as we can see here, I don't know if there's any contact actually made there by KO. It looked like Lil Slinky tried to jump, tried the jump on the straight, yeah. And KO went underneath Lil Slinky. So great call, well, great no call from the refs on that one. We saw it on the replay there, and clearly no contact. Maureen and Gilbert shrugging off Mount Everest round turn one to pick up lead for Kallio.
And there is a star pass been made to Mounty, to Mount Everest, and Bella Glucosi is going to the penalty box for a low block, and is joined by number 96 of Stockholm, that is Linda. I didn't really get that call. And the multiplayer is going to be assessed to number 19 from Kallio, Katie Schrodinger. The cheese ball bearing penalty box is very, very busy during this jam.
Long no pack there, so we're also going to see Fury for the failure to reform.
And sorry, Mount is going to the penalty box for a forearm, so it's a power jam for Kallio.
Nice little joke there from our producer, Schrodinger in the box. For all you physics fans out there.
And there is a very busy box with two blockers and a jammer for Stockholm in there and one player from Kallio rolling rainbow. So this is a power start for Kallio.
And a rush to the track by Kallio.
Well, there's under 3 minutes gameplay left on this first half, so
Chaos is through with lead on the power jam. Sweet Hurt being held in the back by Teabag, KO, and Bella Glucosi. Chaos now starts the move through the Stockholm blockers with Bella Glucosi trying to do some offense. Looks at a cut track picked up by Chaos though. Great move by Sweet, yeah. Just to slide back and draw the foul.
Need to get past those hips correctly.
And more penalty trouble. Cracker now is going to pick up number 6 for a clockwise block.
And Mount Everest is out. And on their first scoring pass, nice little shirt whip there on Sweetheart, who is going out for a clockwise, is getting a seat in the cheese balls bearing penalty box.
So very penalty heavy game so far. And Fury is now also going to the penalty box as we get Chaos returning, followed by Cracker, so the power jam is over.
And Stockholm in a little bit of a penalty trouble. We'll get right back to you on that, how it is.
In fact, that's Cracker fouled out now with a clockwise block, so fouling out in the first period. Chaos now racking up 10 points for Kallio, pushing them into the lead.
And there is a lead change. And right now it's 81-85. Kallio rolling rainbow taking the lead, but an apex jump by the Stockholm jammer. They landed to get all points. We will see that.
And this jam will go the full distance, last few seconds remaining in it, as there is no lead at the moment.
And the jammer landed that apex jump with 1 foot in bounds before taking a knee. So it's a 9-19 jam.
Big jam there for Kallio. And looks like we're going to get an official review for Kallio now,
which is brought to you by Triple Eight. Helmets, pads, wrist guards, we've got you covered.
Kallio are using their official review as a timeout.
So there you go. So they're just using a timeout.
Yeah, thank you. We'll be talking about Triple H, who is protecting derby since day one and protecting against rotational violence with MIPS patented brain protection system. Go to their website, triplea.com, to find out more. So that's a good thing. Taking your official review as a team timeout, I think Kallio wants to ride this wave that they've had. They've had an amazing... The last three, four jams, they only scored 5 points until this one where they scored 19.
And just to remind you, if you're listening to us on the audio coverage only, it's not too late to get your high-quality video feed. It's just $16.99. That's US dollars for the weekend. There's still three great games left to go and the remainder of this nail-biter of a game that we've got between Stockholm and Kallio Rolling Rainbow. So in the halftime, which will be coming up very soon, if you're listening to this and you want to see what's going on, you want to see what all this action is, get over to wftda.tv and get your pass for the rest of the weekend. So we're going to see Lil Slinky and Jay Karpov, which is the first time I think we've seen them on the jamming. Second time, sorry, I'm being instructed. We've seen them jamming for Kallio. Karpov takes the bounce to the outside, but it's quickly back on. Lil Slinky holds the feet. Going around turn one, just rolls the shoulder of Doomy behind and picks up lead for Stockholm. Karpov being held in turn one, but is doing a good job of just avoiding the hits. Doomy behind puts out Lil Slinky, but in the same move, Karpov is knocked to the outside of turn one. We've got the entire pack rolling all the way back to the jam line.
Excellent blocking in the front by Sweetheart, taking out Karpov and take them back to the end of turn four, right before the jam line. But the pack has still just reached the pivot line. They're just before, right in turn one.
Machu Picchu picked up the forearms. So Lil Slinky is going to get through now for the 5-point pick and be giving us a tied game at the moment. Karpov has the star in hand. Going to look for the star pass, but I think Vatuwima, at the front as the pivot is being held at bay. Testames knocking Vatuwima to the inside, so we might get a chance for the star pass to happen now. Karpov still with it in the hand as Lil Slinky makes a nice dash through turn one to pick up another 5-point pass on the pack. So Stockholm now bridging, opening up the lead.
And Karpov is out with a star in hand, trying to chase the pack. Lil Slinky is through and calling it off. Just grabbing the 2 points, getting Stockholm just over the century mark. 102 for Stockholm, 90 for Kallio in halftime.
So 102 points to 90. We've got 15 minutes of halftime. Stockholm already doing well, but also racking up the penalties. We've already seen Cracker has already fouled out of the game. We've got Mount Neverest is sitting on 4 penalties. Fury, number 55, is on 4 penalties. Testames also on 4 penalties. At the moment, no one really on Kallio is troubling that. We've got a couple on 3, but that could be the undoing of Stockholm going into the second period if they can't keep those penalties in check.
And you can also see that the highest scorer for Stockholm this period has been Lil Slinky with 53 points overall. And in Kallio, you have Sarah Gilbert with 42 points scored. And it feels like it's more even in the Kallio, where Kamasutura has 26 points and Chaos has 22 scored. And it's a three... Gemma rotation strong from Kallio, and Stockholm has had their 4 jammers rotating. They have had a lot of star passes. I would like to see more from Kallio to be together when they do their offense, yeah. Because this, we saw it in this last jam that they didn't really know, are we going offense, are we going defense, how do we do this?
Well, we've got 30 and a half minutes of halftime. I'm sure they'll be discussing that right now in the locker room. So you want to be back here in 30 and a half minutes to join us again to pick up the rest of this game. So we'll be back soon. See you then.
Hello and welcome back to the game between Stockholm Roll Derby and Kallio Rolling Rainbow here at the third day of Wftda Division 1 International Playoffs in Malmö, Sweden. I'm here with Sven.
Hello.
And I'm Dimauer. Or you're Olaf, if someone gets the reference. Shout out at the hashtag talk number 2 Wftda. So what we saw in the first half is that Stockholm had 5 power jams that they were able to capitalize against Kallio Rolling Rainbow. And Kallio only got 2, but they didn't manage to do much with them. And they had almost until jam 14 before they started to racking up points. And we saw the Kallio that maybe we're used to seeing.
Yeah, so it was again a game of momentum shifts, really. And we saw some great strategy at the start of the game, start of the period where Stockholm controlled the jams well.
Yes.
They were shutting down before Kallio could actually put any points on the board, which is why we saw several times where there was control, and even if it was 4 or 5 points going up for Stockholm, it was pushing their lead open away from Kallio.
Yes.
But enough for them to get the lead. However, Kallio did a great job pulling that back, so we're now sitting where we are, 12 points spread in the score so far, 102 to Stockholm, Kallio on 90, ready to go into period 2.
Yes, and we have also Cracker that's fouled out of the game, so Stockholm is down 1 blocker, a very important blocker, so we'll see how they will do in the second half. And who do we have on the start line?
So going into it in the blue for Stockholm is Maureen. And that looks like it's going to be... It's Karma Satura in the white for Kallio. As we go for the rolling whistle, and we're going to get the 5 seconds. And we're in now to period 2. Karma Satura pushing the wall forward, but Maureen is the one able to just avoid the contact and get through to pick up the lead for Stockholm. Karma Satura now being held up at the pivot line. Just barrels over Mount Neverest. Still though stuck up behind Mount Neverest and Sweetheart, able to sidestep and shimmy away through and turn 2.
And there was a low block call assessed to number 9 of Kallio. That's Teabag. Because they were able to take Maureen out on the inside line. I didn't really see that. I saw the hit, but I didn't actually see the low block.
But that's 4 points go for Stockholm as the jam ended. And we're going to go now Lil Slinky versus Gilbert. So this is a jammer pairing I think we've seen a few times already in this game. Stockholm with a slight advantage on track. Kallio now taking the jam line. Lil Slinky just trying to force her way through. And we're actually getting some Gilbert joining the blocking trio to help with the defense. Gilbert thought they'd held the toe stops in the line there, but a great call from the OPR. We had an amazing point of view here from our announcer's box to see that cut track call. So power jam Stockholm, Lil Slinky slides around Machu Picchu and has lead in the bag for Stockholm.
And Teabag is out from the cheese balls bearings penalty box and joining their teammates. We're trying to build up a wall in the front. No pack is called. Stockholm running through.
Little Slinky now in this straight nearest us. Through to pick up 5. Power jam comes to an end as Gilbert now on track and really fighting through the pack. Linda and Neverest to beat and spins off the shoulder of Neverest. 2 point pickup for Lil Slinky in that pass. 7 points in total in the jam, but again, shutting out Kallio.
That's a good point protection from Kallio, because in the previous half, they were giving up, if I can say that, about 10, 18, 15 points when they had a power jam against them. So they must have had a good talk in the locker room. I see Maureen Phillip from Stockholm on the jam line, and I think it's
chaos for Kallio.
Thank you.
Started off crouched down so low we couldn't actually see over the top of Maureen. But Maureen is now stepping up the inside, picks up lead for Stockholm. Chaos races the outside, just avoids a block from Incredible Fox to get through out of the pack.
And a back block is being assessed from Maureen Phillip when they came in hard on the Kallio wall. She's taking a seat in the cheese ball bearings penalty box, and Chaos is through for 5 points.
And we've also got Cutty Schrodinger now going back to the cheese balls bearings penalty box for a clockwise block. So again, the penalties continue to come in this game. Chaos now starting this move on the pack. Just got Scandi Crush to beat, but Scandi Crush able to force Chaos to the outside. Now going to roll all the way back round to the exit of turn one.
And Maureen Phillip is out of the penalty box, battling. Well, not so much, because they had help from Scandi Crush there getting through on the second turn.
Cheeseball's penalty box is now empty. Everyone about to try. Of course, as soon as I say that,
your announcer's curse, number 4444, do me behind, is in the cheeseball pen box with Scandi Crush, who's getting in to take a seat as well. So a 3-3 pack.
So we've got both jammers now being recycled, one on the infield, one on the outfield. Ylva Arnberg just going to take them all the way back as far as they can.
And Kallio Rollendebu, they just came over the century mark, and with additional 4 points, they're in 104 to Stockholm's 126.
So both jammers here able to rack up points. No one's in control. Jam goes the full 2 minutes.
That was an even jam with Stockholm, with Kallio taking over by 1 point. And we have a team timeout taken by Kallio Rolling Rainbow, and that's given to you by 888. Helmets, pads, wrist guards, we've got you covered. Protecting derby since day one, and protecting against rotational violence with MIPS patented brain protection system. Thank you at 888 for keeping us safe.
So we've got another couple of players. We've got Cutty Schrodinger now for Kallio is on 4 penalties. So that's the highest total we've got on penalties. We are seeing lots of penalties in this game, but they do seem mainly to be coming from Stockholm, but they are spreading them out a little bit more now. Testimess, Femme Fury, Mount Neverest still sitting on 4, however.
And it's still the jammers from Kallio going mostly to the penalty box, and that might be the reason why Kallio hasn't scored that many points yet in the game. And we also saw the matchup in the previous two jams, which was Little Slinky against Sarah Gilbert. And you will want to do that, getting your top score jammer against the other top score jammer.
And we're going to see Panic at a Hex against Karma Satura. It's full house on track as we got all 4 blockers from both teams. There's a lot of shoving and pushing as the jammers try to fight their way through as the pack rolls past the pivot line. Panic at a Hex managed to step over the infield, over the apex, picks up lead. Karma Satura gets taken out, but it's through a forearms contact from Test the Mess. That's number 5, keeping your tally at home.
And Test the Mess is now sitting on their 6th penalty currently. So and Kallio has not yet taken a lead jam, even though we're into jam 5 in just about 14 seconds.
So we're going to see Lil Slinky and Gilbert again. Kallio with the 4 blockers on the jam line against 3 Stockholm blockers just slightly in front. Gilbert tries to roll around the outside of Wftda, her own blocker.
And with a nice little shirt assist, Kallio is lead and decides to call it off. And I would say it is because Testimess is standing in the cheese ball bearings penalty box, and they would love to have the pack advantage right now.
Both jammers popped out of the pack at exactly the same point there. So we're going to go now to Maureen against Chaos. As you said there, Tess the Mess still standing in the penalty box. So they're going to be released back to the track very soon. And I think we'll see Tess coming on and trying to provide a bit of offense as we get a very static scrum around the jam line.
And Maureen Phillip taking out and taking back almost to turn four, taking off their cap, and but not attempting to give it to their pivot. But nice shirt whip by Maureen Phillip, who is just out of the pack.
Chaos comes through a scoring pass, calls off the jam, picking up the four. Score now 108, Kallio Rolling Rainbow, 129, Stockholm All-Stars. Still got plenty of time left in this game with over 22 minutes remaining.
This was the second lead for Kallio Rolling Rainbow. So whatever they're doing or whatever they changed in the past two jams works for them. I will dare to say this, but the penalty box is empty.
Well, let's see how long that lasts. We've got Karma Sutura and Lil Slinky on the track. And as soon as you say that, we get a clockwise block called on Teabag from Kallio.
The announcer's curse.
Both jammers are still in the pack trying to fight their way through. And there's a forearms penalty going to be called. That's on Swede Hurt from Stockholm. So that balances up the pack. But we have got Lil Slinky out in front now with lead. Karma Sutura just breaks the pack now on turn one. Half a lap behind as Lil Slinky comes into the pack. That's still sitting on turn one stationary. Clockwise block going to be called. This one going to go to Incredible Fox for Stockholm. So Stockholm going to be reduced blocker lineup in the next jam. Incredible Fox is going to be in the box as the pivot. So we're going to see 3-on-2 in the next jam. But we've got Panic at a Hex and Gilbert in the jammer spots. Gilbert goes round their own wall and forces the way past Mount Everest to pick up a lead for Kallio. Panic at a Hex is now through, half a lap behind. Gilbert coming up, got one to beat. Teabag pushes Test the Mess into the path of Gilbert, trying the apex jump. Gilbert, though, gets through for the 3 points and makes the call off.
Still icing the Stockholm pivot in the cheese ball bearings penalty box. Still sitting down is Foxen. So, but also Vatu Vima, the pivot for Kavli, is also sitting there. So both pivots in the box.
And a great move there by Chaos. Sidestep bounding up the infield line just to pick up lead.
And there was a penalty called on number, a forearm call on the blocker 6-0 from Kallio Rolling Rainbow.
That's KO from Kallio.
And that was a 0-0 jam.
Again, we're seeing lots of fast call-offs here. Points denial, but still only a 22-point gap between Stockholm on 133, Kallio on 111. Just under 20 minutes to play in the game. Now Stockholm have the pack advantage 4-on-2. Karma Sutura and Lil Slinky lining up behind that jam line. Straight into it now. Stockholm trying to hold the four together. Lil Slinky bounced to the outside by Teabag. Is Karma Sutura able to beat the Stockholm four? Pick up lead, Lil Slinky though, about 25 feet behind Karma Sutura as we race up to the pack. The pack now picking up speed, but we've got Linda takes a stumble. 2 points picked up by Karma Sutura, but 4 points picked up by Lil Slinky in that one. Able to race those whistles and get in before the jam was ended to pick up the four for Stockholm.
When you do that, when you're waiting for your jammer before you race up and you're in the back of the pack, you need to be sure that you're able to race up so fast that the other jammer won't be able to come after you.
Yeah, it's always a thing of timing a call-off, of course, so that the signal gets to the jammer, if the jammer starts the call and the whistles, the first four whistles end before, of course, the other jammer gets through and scores. But now we've got Maureen is up against Gilbert. It's a very tight pack. Not moved much, has only moved a few feet since the whistle went. It's now up to the pivot line. Gilbert wrestles her way around. Incredible Fox to pick up lead. Now Maureen Phillip out of the pack. Gilbert is coming around to start the first scoring pass.
And we see that even when Gilbert is on track and taking lead, they're scoring only 1, 2 points, 3 points. It's never multiple passes. Kallio needs to be able to do more multiple passes. I think they have not. They've only had one multiple pass, and that was during a power jam in the beginning of this half. So they really need to think about how they will be able to capitalize when they have lead.
Well, those multiple passes came about in that jam where there was no lead because lead was lost, and so both jammers were just allowed to carry on scoring. Panic at the hex for Stockholm. Tries to find a way at the outside. Just got Bella Glucosi to beat, but KO comes up in support.
And two blockers for Kallio taking a seat in the penalty box. So with a 2-2-3 advantage, Panika is going to run this jam.
No, we're getting a call off from the bench. Just before Chaos could get in and get the point. So again, we're seeing Stockholm controlling the jams well.
Yeah, as soon as they got out their blockers from the box, they just called the jam and said no. Icing two blockers from Kallio in the cheese ball bearings penalty box.
Karma Satura and Lil Slinky. Stockholm bracing with the back wall. Lil Slinky just drops Karma Satura off with the wall and then tries to find a way around. Hopping the skip and makes it up to pick lead for Stockholm. Karma Satura, though, still just facing down with Scandi Crush. Now being held in behind Eva Arnberg, and Incredible Fox makes a star pass to Machu Picchu.
And did you see that apex jump from Lil Slinky? Let's see it again. No. Oh, nice duck from Lil Slinky. That's how you get 3 and 4 points.
So we can see Machu Picchu now putting the star back on, and Lil Slinky gets the call from the bench, picks up 9 in the jam for Stockholm, taking them to 150 points. Kallio Rolling Rainbow still stuck on 115, 15 minutes 46 remaining in the game.
And there on the replay you saw the apex jump from Lil Slinky, and now here comes the duck. Look at beautiful down and hopping and skip on the outside line out of turn 3. And Boda Fatale says, that was brilliant work by Kallio's blockers to hold the jammer when down by two blockers. At our hashtag talk, number 2, WFTDA.
And now we've got Maureen and Gilbert. Gilbert takes a whip around the outside, picks up lead for Kallio. We've had a star pass. That star pass has gone off to Mount Everest, who we've seen take the star pass already in the game. So Kallio in control. Gilbert facing down against Tess the Mess is through to pick up 5 points. It looks like we've got, all right, so the star pass.
There's something going on here. The Mount Everest thought they were the jammer, but then they were not, and now there was an insubordination call.
So I think what's happened there is there's a star pass violation, so the jammer goes to the box, but Mount Everest thought she was the jammer, therefore got an out of play call, so would have picked up the out of play penalty, then didn't follow the referee's instructions because Mount Everest went to try and hand the jammer star back instead of reporting the penalty box, at which point they pick up the second penalty for the insubordination.
Yes. It's so nice to announce with someone who is so good at rules. And it's amazing. And Maureen Phillip out of the penalty box, star in hand, getting out of their initial pass. But Sarah Gilbert says, I'm going to call it off. Put 16 points on the board. That's the biggest jam in this half for Kallio.
We need to check it as well, but I think we also might be seeing Mount Everest on 7 penalties.
Yes, it seems like there's going to be a foul out. And there is your officials team timeout presented by officials timeout. sorry, presented to you by the 888. That is protecting derby since day one. Please visit the 888.com for more information. And there seems to be a lot of talking going on with Iceman going to the penalty box to talk and check that, see that everything's okay. Mercy Boku ready to help Mount Everest off the track. Or, yep. And we can see from here the beautiful Kallio Rolling Rainbow cheering squad with a big flag. We love KRR. Very happy. And there are a lot of people in the hall for this first game, and I'm expecting to see more cheering for the rest of the day because the day isn't done yet. We're just starting.
So it looks like we're just doing some admin and some work around that scenario that we had there. It's one of those confusing scenarios where, because everything happened so fast and the pivot, who's obviously just taken the star now, the new jammer, wants to take off as fast as possible. It's sometimes by the time they've got their brain in gear is the fact that they're getting called out of play, they're already racing away, and they don't quite fully understand the situation. But of course, they've got the penalty at that point. If that caused confusion that they'd want to go back and try and hand the star back, that's what causes the insubordination. Of course, if you don't get straight, if you don't make moves immediately to move to remove yourself from the track, you're going to get the insubordination, and that's what we just saw there happening.
Yeah, and when you don't see it from here, if we don't see it, then we don't really know what's going on. But it still looks like Glenn of Ording has everything in order. He's the Glenn of Order for the Stockholm bench. They still look calm, but two foul outs in this game, it's hard for Stockholm. They're down to 12 players now.
It looks like we're going to get Duncan Disorderly on the microphone.
Let's hear what they have to say.
The Stockholm blocker was originally assessed to have fouled out. One of her penalties was removed, so she has been brought back into the game.
Okay, then.
So that was Mount Everest. So it looks as though there was a bit of confusion there in terms of how many penalties were assessed, how many penalties that blocker has sat. So Mount Everest hasn't fouled out yet, but is still sitting on six, so is very much in the danger zone. Cue yeah. Everyone at home playing Kenny Loggins.
However, so Mount Everest taking a seat in the penalty box as the pivot.
Yep, still as the pivot. And we're going to get back underway now with Chaos lining up for Kallio. And it looks like it's going to be Lil Slinky for Stockholm. Chaos makes the move up the outside line. Lil Slinky just muscled off by the behind of Doobie Behind.
And Chaos takes lead. Chaos has scored 40 points in this game so far for Kallio.
Lil Slinky is now out of the pack on the initial pass. Chaos, being forced to recycle, sees Lil Slinky coming around turn three and calls off the jam.
And we are waiting for points for Kallio as divide by zero. The jam ref is talking to their outer puck ref, and there was 0 points, so a 0-0 jam.
So still 12 minutes 50 in the game. Very much all to play for. Only 19 points of spread. 1-3-1 for Kallio players. 1-5-0 of Stockholm. And it's going to be Panica de Hex and Karma Satura jamming in this one. Mount Everest is released from the box and back on track. Both jammers struggling to find a path through. Panica de Hex is currently making the most movement up front, beats Bella Glucosi, rolls around Cutty Schrodinger, picks up lead for Stockholm. However, Karma Satura is behind now, 30 feet separate the two jammers. Pack moving round into this pack, into this back straight, picking up speed. I think we're going to see Panica de Hex trying to get the quick call off. Unfortunately, Kallio, great work by them to hold the front, keep out of the way, and no points picked up. Sorry, 1 point looked like picked up by Kallio by the downed Stockholm blocker that fell in the pack as the pace was creeping up.
Yes, this jam, the last jam, they did it right. They took the front, they raced it, they held it. Sarah Gilbert on the line with Maureen Phillip. Two great jammers during this game.
Tight pack as we go into the turn one corner. Multiplayer block call is going to come for Swedhurt. And we've got Sarah Gilbert out now with lead. Half a lap behind is Maureen Phillip. Gilbert goes round Scandi Crush, calls off the jam. 2 points for Scandi Crush plus Swedhurt in the box.
Swedhurt currently sitting on 4 penalties. And I see how Stockholm has a lot of penalty troubles, but still able to capitalize on the track, so they must be doing something right.
Yeah, but they've managed to, some of the players who were in trouble earlier in the game have managed to keep it clean for now, but they are still walking the tightrope of being on 5 and 6 penalties. So now Chaos moving out to in, picks up lead for Kallio. Lil Slinky got star in hand, going to look for the star pass to Mount Neverest. Goes past Mount Neverest and is just going to try and work the way through turn one, but got a nice little pivoting 3 of Kallio blockers holding in place.
And we have a Kallio skater going to the box for a clockwise block.
It was Doomy behind it was going to the box there. Sitting now at Cheese Balls Bearings penalty box. Lil Slinky now coming up to the pack. Chaos, I don't know if she reacted quick enough to get that call off.
Didn't he? 4-0 during that jam. Crowd's not liking it. So the score right now is 150 to Stockholm and 138 for Kallio Rolling Rainbow with just under 10 minutes left on this half. It's a 12-point jam. Am I getting that right? It's a 12-point jam. Game. I mean, it's a 12-point game.
Yeah, 12-point game. Phillip, I think, is going to pick up maybe forearms. Yep, forearms for that block. So power jam, Kallio, Karmazatura also gets the back block. So we're going to see both jammers go into the box, which means when we come out, we'll be going the full 2 minutes. Doomy behind, released, followed by Phillip with cap in hand.
And Kallio is taking the front with a full pack of blockers there, holding back Maureen.
Scandi Crush makes it the move up the inside to stop Karmazatura, who's out of the box now, completes the initial pass. Phillip completes the initial pass this time with a cap off now. The star is back on.
And there, with less than one minute left on this jam 19, we have Kallio putting up the first scores on the board with 4 points, and then Phillip just coming out with their additional 3 points.
3 points, there was a no pass, no penalty on turn one.
And a nice toe stopping there on the inside line out of turn two.
So both jammers now are just gonna have to keep moving and scoring. Good awareness there by Phillip to see Machu Picchu trying to draw the cut. I think it was the fact that Machu Picchu was signaling the cut to the ref that alerted Phillip that they needed to come back on and seed.
And 10 seconds left on the jam, and Maureen Phillip still trying to get this point. And no pass, no penalty, 4 points.
Karmazatura at the back, just being worked around by Scandi Crush.
And Kallio won that jam with 13 points to 5. A 6-point game with just under 7 minutes left. Wow. It reminds me of yesterday's game between London and Rainy City. What's going to happen?
Let's see if Stockholm's penalty trouble is going to come back to bite them in this last 7 minutes as we go to Panic at a Hex and Sarah Gilbert online jamming through. Sarah Gilbert with the first move through. Got the four Stockholm blockers though up front and managing to hold the pack in front.
And Sarah Gilbert taking lead. This is the sixth lead out of seven jams that Sarah has been on the track. Wow. During the second half. Thank you, my producer.
Sarah Gilbert picks up the quick 3 points. Calls off the jam.
157 to 154. 3 point game so far. Stockholm is leading with 6 minutes left on the period clock during the second half.
So a little slinky and chaos. We're 4-on-4, full house on track. Little slinky tries to make the outside move, managed to use a toe stop run, picks up lead for Stockholm. Chaos is stuck in the quagmire that is that pack right now, moving past the pivot line. Just being muscled off the track by Sweetheart, now held in place by Sweetheart and Incredible Fox. Little Slinky is coming through the back for the first start, scoring pass. Just held up between Teabag and Watavima with KO holding. Scandi Crush comes in on the offense. Watavima picks up an elbow, so that takes some of the pressure off Little Slinky, who manages to duke around Bella Glucosi. Little Slinky now out. 5 point pass.
And another blocker for Kallio going to the penalty box for a clockwise block. That is number 6-0 KO. So with two blockers down now.
Little Slinky now starting his second scoring pass on the pack. And another 5 points picked up. Just taking the quick route through turn three.
And number 4-4. And your captain for Stockholm, Ylva, is taking a seat in the cheese ball bearings penalty box. And a failure to reform going over to Scandicrush is also taking a seat.
I think it was a destroying the pack, as it was called by the referees. So that was the initial pack destruction. Little Slinky comes into the pack, managed to sneak the hips past, pick up 2 points. So that opens the lead right up now for Stockholm. 174, players 154, 4 minutes remaining in this game.
Yes, and we want to thank our host, League Crime City Rollers, for getting us here to Malmö for this Wftda International Division 1 playoffs 2017.
Sarah Gilbert and Panic at Hex. Panic at Hex holds a footing going up that inside line, picks up lead for Stockholm. Sarah Gilbert goes face to face with Mount Everest. Test the mess, just helping Mount Everest in place. Now Ylva Arnberg also there, but we've got Machu Picchu going up in support of Sarah Gilbert, who is able to get out of the pack now on the initial pass.
And Doomy behind going to the cheese ball bearings penalty box for a clockwise block. And Panica looking at their bench saying, okay, we're calling it off. 2 points. And there is a team timeout for Kallio Rolling Rainbow. That's brought to you by 888. Helmets, pads, three squads, we've got you covered. Protecting derby since day one and protecting against rotational violence with MIPS patented brain protection system. The Wftda would like to also thank S1, Rydell, Adam Skates, Quad Skate Shop, Double Thread Skates, AAA, Cheeseball Bearings, Sucker Punch Skate Shop, Derby Central, 5&5 Magazine, and RollerCon for getting us here and making it able for us to be here. All the languages in my head scrambling up like eggs. Okay, wow, what an exciting game. It is still, how many points are there? It's 176 until
22 points.
22 points, thank you.
So 22 point game, 3 minutes, 8 seconds left. Kama Satura and Maureen Phillip lining up. It's four on three pack advantage in favour of Stockholm, who are taking the jam line start and holding up tight. Philip is just helping bolster that wall to stop Carmacity from getting through before moving in and making the moves on the Kallio defence. Pack has now moved slightly up towards the pivot line. Philip now being rolled all the way back down by Watavima. And we've got a bit of a pile up. Swede Hurt and Bella Glucosi going down, but it's Philip is through for lead. And we've got...
And there seems to be something going on there with Kamasutra, who thought they had a penalty, but they didn't. So their jam ref went to the penalty box and said, you didn't get a penalty, come back on track.
It looks like it was Bella Glucosi, 1-0-3, they got a low block penalty. Kamasutra somehow heard the 3 and the 1 and thought they had the penalty, and so headed off to our cheese balls bearings penalty box. However, not a power jam, but Philip is just going to try and make moves on the pack like it is a power jam.
And we see Glenn of Orning signaling to Marine to just keep going because they want to burn the clock down.
And Ilva Arnberg picks up a forearms penalty as we see Kamasutra being taken all the way back to turn one. Took the start off briefly, looking for the pass, but puts it back straight on.
The 36 seconds left on this jam, and just under, just over 1.5 minutes left on this game.
Kamasutra able to bounce around, picks up the no pass, no penalty, but had previously scored, so does have the 4 points in the bag.
And a low block assess to Maureen Philip, who goes to the penalty box with 11 seconds left of this jam. So it power jam start for Kallio if their jammer manages to stay on track for the next 2 seconds, which they do.
However, it will be a power start now for Kallio. 1 minute left in the game. 184 points to Stockholm. 163 points to Kallio. 21 point difference.
Yeah, and we'd also, the Wftda and Crime City Rolls would like to thank these companies for the generous support that this weekend's event. Double Cross Clothing, Steaks, Edgy Veggie, Oakley Steaks, Mullins Falafel, and Chaya Skates.
So Sarah Gilbert on the power start for Kallio.
And a Stockholm skater, 6-7, Test and Mess, for a cutting the track, going to the cheeseball bearings penalty box now.
No pack was called. I think we might see some out of play blocking there. We do. KO for Kallio. Goes to cheese balls, bearings penalty box, picks up the failure to reform. Philip is back to track, completes the initial pass. Sarah Gilbert in the first scoring pass. Just has Linda to beat.
And the Pyrocloud has run out, but... And Kallio does not have the time to ask for a team timeout or their official review. There's talking going on in the middle.
I think the jam timer was signaling that there was no time left available for a timeout. And the referees seem like they're not going for a timeout, so it looks like that is the end of the game.
And your the score is 184 to Stockholm and 166 to Kallio. Still unofficial, waiting for the official score to get up. It's final. So we had the highest scoring jammer for Stockholm has been Lil Slinky with 94 points and Sarah Gilbert for Kallio with 71 points scored during this game.
Impressively though, Lil Slinky did that zero penalties all the way through the game, which, considering the penalty record of Stockholm, very impressive. High numbers there. We had one foul out. We got Mount Everest end the game on 6. We had Test the Mess on 6. And we had Femme Fury on 5. So quite a lot of penalties for Stockholm. However, 22 points, such a close game. Kallio just didn't have the momentum. Stockholm able to get lead, I think, for most of the first half. Looks like Kallio did a good job of securing lead in the second half, is not able to make any headway with those leads.
Yeah, Kallio had just as the same second half of the first half. The second half, they also waited until jump 9 before something started to happen. But great game. It was a close one. It's a great game to kick off the third day of the Wftda Division 1 playoffs here in Sweden, Malmö.
And that just shows you how close the games are going to be in this final day. So again, last another chance for us to say that if you if you're listening on the free audio stream and you want to actually see what's going on here on this track, get yourself to wftda.tv and get access to the high quality video feed for just $16.99.
And please tune in for our next game, which is Charm City against Rainy City.
And of course, Rainy City are probably going to be coming out now after that brutal game against London, and they're going to be wanting to make some noise in this game. They're going to want to pick their heads up after that game, because let's face it, the fight in that game was intense, and they just want to prove now that they can actually come back and show everybody that they are going to take the next level in this tournament.
Thank you very much for today. We're going to give the mic over to our people down on the floor.
It looks like it's Dark Mistress with three of Kallio, and see, definitely Teabag. So we will be handing off down to Dark Mistress on the floor in just a moment.
Incredible game against Stockholm.
Oh yeah, man. What,
again, you've played them 6 times now, less than 20 points. How was that game?
That was awesome. That was that was incredible. What a game to end this season. Yeah. Okay, I wish the last jumps would have gone a bit differently, but I mean, we're in great spirits anyway. That's a great result. Stockholm is such a great team. They put on amazing points yesterday against Denver, so Wow, I'm really glad. I'm really glad about this result.
And this is your second time at playoffs. How did you prepare for this?
Practicing. Practice and gathering our team together. We have a lot of new players who have stepped it up. Yeah. So we have worked on team spirit. And actually this year we worked really hard on getting our team enjoy the game. Yeah. Just enjoy, have fun, whether you lose, whether you win, just have fun and enjoy. And that's roller derby, having fun and not only the tears.
And we really succeed with it.
Yes. Yeah?
Yes.
You guys did awesome. Talking of spirit, I heard you all had to choose a spirit animal for this tournament. Who did you pick?
Okay, you start.
I'm a horse.
Yeah?
Yeah, because I'm wild and free, they say. I don't know.
I'm a kangaroo. I like to jump around.
Okay. I'm a flying squirrel, and I just fly.
She does. She does.
Congratulations, guys. You had
an
awesome tournament. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone at home. Salapulla, we love you.